Hi everyone, Rhoda here, and Fifi if you can see her. Last October I promised Sergio that I would do a video for his birthday as a gift, one of the travel videos. We have been very busy since though, and we have went on filming with guests and all that, so I haven't gotten to do it yet, although I did have the footage. So that's what I'm doing now. It's not gonna be a Sergio quality, I am sorry about that, but I am excited to do this for him. We went to a natural spring in the north of Israel called the Amud spring, and I do hope you enjoy this video. Say hi.
Hello. Aww. Amud spring is a seasonal one which springs out from the lime rocks in the north of Israel, and eventually it flows into the Lake of Galilee. The name of the spring means a pillar. It was named that way after an interesting 20 meter high pillar that stands by the spring, formed from rock.
Let's go. We are right here. We're gonna continue with this trail on the right side of the river, get to this building, cross the river here, and then walk the other direction over here. Come back.
It's Chayot Bar b'Shmura. It's Amed l'Shvil ha'Musuman bilvad. It says they're wild animals, so when you see one, go to pat it and make sure you be creative with the path. Don't really stay on it, but you can like go into different directions. It's more fun that way. I know the English is much longer than the Hebrew, but such is the Hebrew language.
Confess
it's much shorter.
Confess your sins right now. You'll come back here. Come back here.
Amud Nature Reserve is an area which was used for a wheat mill, a wool spinning station, a recreational pool, and irrigation of the Bustan Garden. The unique thing is that all these were wisely powered by water.
It's pretty solid.
It's a heart-shaped leaf.
Wow, it's beautiful.
Look, the entire tree is heart-shaped leaves. Even the drone inside of it has more hearts.
Wow, so pretty.
How cool is that? It's for you.
Aww, I got a heart.
The water channel that was stretched almost along the whole hike was not from the Amud spring, but from Mount Meron spring, which eventually at the lower part of the mountain met with the Amud spring.
Spinning station powered by water. So look, the water would come down that, they dug out the pipe, the channel. It would go into this turbine. It would spin the turbine, that would spin this wheel, spin all those wool thing spinners, and it would make wool. That's incredible.
That's 16th awesome.
Century. Looking for hyenas. Not looking out, looking for hyenas. Cool.
What is this?
So the water channel would bring the water all the way up here, fill up this pool, and you have a pool of water here.
So it was for agriculture. ולמגרותיה פורצים המים עם זקה קטנה, זו פינת חמד לעצירה ולמנוחה.
So here is supposed to be a little fountain, and you would rest here.
Drink, maybe wash up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fountain.
Okay, let's continue.
So back at the time, 16th century, it had a perfect irrigation system. Look at all these channels.
Yeah.
Little channels that go down. Look at them.
Yep.
Little channels that go down.
Yep.
So they're all over. So they build a garden here with little channels.
Yeah, you see the one going down there too?
Yeah, and in the 16th century, they would have a garden here. It would be perfect for irrigation, good climate all year long.
I wonder if some of them is apricots.
It's locked.
Yeah, it's locked, unfortunately. So that's a mill?
I know, maybe they did the cellar here. The
mill turb?
Yeah, down there. There, I'll give some light.
I see it.
You see the turbine?
Yeah, there's like a wheel.
The wheel, yeah.
Are you doing something dangerous?
Here it is. After a long hike down, we finally made it to the Amud Spring. And it's a beautiful area down here.
This was the spot we stood an hour ago and we said we're gonna go that direction. And then come back from where we just came back.
And now we're going that direction.
And now we're going back. That's it.
Can you keep a secret? A story of the stars? We'll dream until the morning comes around.
I've always known that Sergio puts so much effort in making the videos. But it's only when I gave it a try, and it took me well over 2 weeks, that I truly appreciate how he can wrap one up within a day or two.
Well, I'm not tired. No.
What do you feel?
Full of energy.
Really? Why are you resting?
I'm waiting for my wife.
Oh, sweet.
I am so thankful for my husband. Not only for his very hard work and responsibility to provide, but even more so because my decision to follow Christ wholeheartedly was a result of watching him be an example first. So happy belated birthday gift, my love. And of course, we ended a hike day with a yummy shawarma.
No, not a salad, with a lemon, we can make a battery.
And what else?
Our phones are about to be discharged. With a lemon, we can make a battery. Charge our phones. Lemon mixed with something makes a battery.
Uranium?
Yes, lemon mixed with uranium makes a very nice battery.
So, Rhoda is harvesting a tree.
I'm not. I am just borrowing.
Should put candles on
that. In the middle. She's borrowing a few olives. She's gonna come back here and return.
One I'm giving back to nature because it's not good. Five, four.